Assalamualaikum. My name is Muhammad Tanzeel and I'm a medical final year medical student at Dow Medical College. My MCAT score was 90.
So Tanzeel, which coachings do you prefer for your MCAT preparation?
I took my MCAT coaching classes from Anisa Sam, so I would prefer that. I was really satisfied from my teachers and administration over there. So yeah, it's cool.
Any other coachings, do you think they were more reliable than that?
I think there's Doctorzin as well. There are many people at Dow, my colleagues that are from Doctorzin. But the time that I took my coaching classes, Doctorzin had closed their registration. So yeah, I had the only option. I didn't send. It was also close by my house, so it was feasible, convenient. There were my friends there from college, so yeah.
Do you think self-study is also an option?
Self-study, I guess, is one of the very major options, despite the fact whatever tuition you take, because you yourself are the only person capable of getting into Dow. So yeah, self-study is one option, but obviously notes vagera ke liye, you have to take guidance from someone. So if there is some friend or some senior who can provide you that guidance, so self-study is a very great option. I wouldn't say no to that.
When did you start your preparation?
I started my preparation right after my Cambridge exams. That was 19th May 2016. And my Dow test was on November. I think October mein tha, but that event kept on postponing and then was November. So I had quite a few months.
What were the book sources and notes or any other items you used?
So I was a Cambridge board student, so I had no idea what there was in the SINDH boards. So I bought all the six books, physics, chemistry, bio, first year, second year, and I thoroughly read them line by line, or I memorized almost all of that. So yeah, I had to give them a thorough read, plus I used the Anisa Sen MCAT 1 and MCAT 2 guidebooks. There were worksheets or test questions. Then doctors in KP, I had worksheets from my friends. So I used that, and I guess that was it for me, because Cambridge board ki wajah se I knew a lot about the MCQs from Red Spot, so I didn't have to do them again.
So was it difficult as a Cambridge board student to be suddenly in SINDH board?
Okay, difficult, yeah, difficult. It was a nightmare in that time. I mean, if somebody mujhe kitne bhi paise de de, I wouldn't go back. That time was a nightmare.
Yeah.
So, it was difficult, but it is doable. Lots of people do it, theek hai, har saal. So yeah, it's challenging, but if you are consistent, you can do that.
Great. So, what do you think, how many hours you have actually put into the study schedule of yours?
As much as I could.
Yeah.
So basically, I started with 3-4 hours, but then I increased the depth, especially Ramzan ke baad, I increased to about 10 hours per day. So bas I used to start, then I used to go to Anisa Sen. I used to start from early morning, like 6 baje, 7 baje or jo, and then I used to study. I used to go to Anisa Sen, my class thi, then I used to come back, phir ghar baith ke, I used to revise the notes. If I had any problems, I used to mark them, and I used to, you know, ask them the next day from my teachers, Anisa Sen pe the. So that is how I studied, and I basically did an integrated studying. I did not do it subject wise, because 100 marks of questions hote hain and you get everything in one paper. So I preferred integrated studying. I did first years and then second years.
So according to you, which subjects do you think you should complete first?
Which subject? I would suggest if you are going for subject wise studying, I would say you do physics first, because it's more of concepts and mathematics, so you need to grab concept, and keep biology for the end because it's mostly rata, say, so kingdoms and all that thing. So yeah, if you're doing it subject wise, you should do it that way, but I prefer integrated studying. That's a better option.
So as a Cambridge student and from coming from an A-levels background, what do you think, it was advantages for you or some kind of disadvantages for you?
I think it is both, say, because you have a better idea about the MCQs thing, you have a better idea of using the MCQ sheet, or you know how to just how to study from more resources and not just the course books. Silava, the disadvantage was reading all 6 books for the first time, and also jo NTS ka atmosphere hota hai, we are not accustomed to that, no fans, gandhi mitti har jagah. I know it sounds pretty weird, but I had to practice for that. I had to practice for giving my exams or mock exams. Pankha band karke ghar mein room mein baithta tha. And that really helped psychologically because you actually mentally prepared for what is yet to come. So yeah.
So you were actually preparing for the government university to come.
I was. But I'm in my government university and we are air conditioned on campus at the UDS. So.
Okay. So I think, okay. So what advice you are going to give to your juniors, what to do for, not only for the MCAT preparation, but for the MCAT day? Us din par kya karna chahiye specifically?
Sabse pehle to, you know, take, okay, now it's very important that you have soul sahi se. Because maine aaj tak jo bhi exam thi, I took my sleep proper, that is one thing. Secondly, you cannot revise everything on that day. So just focus on some things, jo ke passive mein zyada hai nahi hai, you could go through those, your notes sharp mein banaye. Thirdly, take good breakfast and pray for it. I guess that is what's going to help.
Okay. And what is the thing you actually regret that maybe you wish that you could have done it and it would be much more better?
I actually do not regret anything.
That's good.
At the moment, because I'm in doubt. But yeah, I regret agar mujhe, you know, somebody could have taught me a much more better personal experience. Some senior could have guided me at that time. Like, you know, just as a YouTube channel ke through you are getting guidance, that would have been much more appropriate. Because getting guidance exactly hota kya hai, how to enter DAO, it is really tough. So you get tips and bits because government university ke administration is not going to tell you anything. They are so poor.
So during your whole MCAT journey, right, you call it as a nightmare for every student. What do you think?
The MCAT months.
Okay, so it's for everybody, I think, for everyone,
for
it was a nightmare. So how do you use to control your anxiety and, you know, during the, those days?
Yeah, so I used to tell myself that there are so many people who can do it, so I can do it. You have to believe in yourself. Perseverance is what is needed. And you need to be consistent. You need to ask from your teachers how you can make it doable. And perseverance, practice, 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 that you need to do.
Okay, so the specific questions are that, okay, so organic chemistry is found to be very difficult for, you know, juniors. So how to prepare for chemistry, like specifically organic chemistry?
Okay, coming from a Cambridge background, we have a much, we have a better grasp of our organic chemistry. So it wasn't, and I like organic chemistry, so it wasn't really difficult. But I think past papers really helped. Because once you're reading them, you need to go to a worksheet with past papers to get a more. So organic chemistry was one of my favorites, so I did not really face much difficulty in that, but students do have it, so I would give them a suggestion of doing past papers. You know, doing alkanes, alkenes, and going for past papers from that, topical past papers, and that is how I got grasp over that.
And what do you think, how to do physics without calculator?
Okay, yeah, so coming from a Cambridge background, it's advantages for me because we have short solutions for everything because MCQs mein hamare paas isi tarah aata tha. So we had short formula for those things. But Anisa Sen pe, there was this teacher, Sir Masood, who taught us.
Yeah.
So he gave us all those formulas. So practice is one thing that is going to take time. You have to give physics time. It is one of the most difficult subjects, especially for medical students, because there's so much maths.
Thank you so much, Sanjeev.
You're welcome.